Once when Hyakujo delivered some Zen lectures, an old man attended them, unseen by the monks.
Good evening. It's so good of you to come.
At the end of each talk, when the monks left, so did he.
Good evening. It's so good of you to come. It's so good of you to come.
But one day he remained after they had gone, and Hyakujo asked him, "Who are you?" The old man replied,
I am not a human being.
I am not a human being.
But I was a human being when the Kashapa Buddha preached in this world.
But I was a human being when the Kashapa Buddha preached in this world.
I was a Zen master and lived on this mountain.
I was a Zen master and lived on this mountain.
At that time, one of my students asked me whether or not the enlightened man is subject to the law of causation.
At that time, one of my students asked me whether or not the enlightened man is subject to the law of causation.
I answered him, the enlightened man is not subject to the law of causation.
I answered him, the enlightened man is not subject to the law of causation.
For this answer, evidencing a clinging to absoluteness, I became a fox for 500 rebirths, and I am still a fox.
For this answer, evidencing a clinging to absoluteness, I became a fox for 500 rebirths, and I am still a fox.
Will you save me from this condition with your Zen words and let me get out of the fox's body?
Will you save me from this condition with your Zen words and let me get out of a fox's body?
Now may I ask you, is the enlightened man subject to the law of causation?
Now may I ask you, is the enlightened man subject to the law of causation? Hyakujo said, the enlightened man is one with the law of causation. At the words of Hyakujo, the old man was enlightened. I am emancipated, he said, paying homage with a deep bow.
I am emancipated. I am no more a fox, but I have to leave my body and my dwelling place behind this mountain.
I am no more a fox, but I have to leave my body and my dwelling place behind this mountain.
Please perform my funeral as a monk.
Please perform my funeral as a monk. Then he disappeared.
A legend in his own time. It saddens me to have to tell the many fans and friends that he died just one day before this interview was to have taken place. Good night, and sincerely yours.
The next day, Hyakujo gave an order through the chief monk to prepare to attend the funeral of a monk. No one was sick in the infirmary, wondered the monks. What does our teacher mean? After dinner, Hyakujo led the monks out and around the mountain. In a cave with his staff, he poked out the corpse of an old fox and then performed the ceremony of cremation. That evening, Hyakujo gave a talk to the monks and told them this story about the law of causation. Obaku, upon hearing the story, asked Hyakujo, "I understand that a long time ago, because a certain person gave a wrong Zen answer, he became a fox for 500 rebirths. Now I want to ask, if some modern master is asked many questions and he always gives the right answer, what will become of him?" Hyakujo said, "You come here near me and I will tell you." Obaku went near Hyakujo and slapped the teacher's face with his hand, for he knew this was the answer his teacher intended to give him. Hyakujo clapped his hands and laughed at this discernment. "I thought a Persian had a red beard," he said, "and now I know a Persian who has a red beard."
"It's for the wife."
"Oh, 20 shekels.
Right.
What? There you are. Wait a minute.
What?
Well, we're supposed to haggle.
No, I've got to get...
What do you mean, no?
I haven't got time.
Well, give it back then.
No, I just paid you.
What?
Yeah.
This bloke won't haggle.
Won't haggle?
All right.
Do we have to?
Now, look, I want 20 for that.
I just gave you
20. Now, are you telling me that's not worth 20 shekels?
No.
Look at it. Feel the quality. That's none of your goat.
All right, I'll give you 19 then.
No. Come on, do it properly.
What?
Haggle properly. This isn't worth 19.
You just said it was worth 20.
Oh, dear. Come on, haggle.
All right, I'll give you 10.
That's more like it. 10? Are you trying to insult me? Me with a poor dying grandmother? 10?
All right, I'll give you 11.
Now you're getting it. 11? Did I hear you right? 11? This cost me 12. You want to ruin me?
17?
No. 17.
18?
No, you get a 14 now.
All right, I'll give you 14.
14? Are you joking?
That's what you told me to say.
Oh, dear.
Oh, tell me what to say, please.
Hyakujo said, "You come here near me and I will tell you." Obaku went near Hyakujo and slapped the teacher's face with his hand, for he knew this was the answer his teacher intended to give him. Hyakujo clapped his hands and laughed at this discernment. "I thought a Persian had a red beard," he said, "and now I know a Persian who has a red beard."
"It's for the wife."
Mu-mon's comment. The enlightened man is not subject. How can this answer make the monk a fox? The enlightened man is one with the law of causation. How can this answer make the fox emancipated? To understand this clearly, one has to have just one eye. Controlled or not controlled? The same dice shows two faces. Not controlled or controlled, both are a grievous error.